Time Heist. What a cracking episode. In this adventure, we see the Doctor and his gang of misfits break into the most secure bank in the universe. Join us as we unlock the secrets that made up this cunning caper.
Shut down!
A trip to the bank can be a scary experience. And on Doctor Who, it's no different, especially when it's run by such a terrifying manager. But how did the producers end up casting Keeley Hawes?
Douglas McKinnon came on as director, and he suggested Keeley. Of course, she's fantastic in Line of Duty. She's an extraordinary actress. So we very excitedly said yes, and she's just so funny and so clever.
And what did Peter think about having Keeley on board?
I've worked with Keeley before. She's wonderful. Brings great grace and class to the show and great humour. So it was a delight to have her on that.
Yay! Doctor Who!
With the excitement of landing the role, how did Keeley's children react when she told them the good news?
Usually, if I'm asked to do something, I'll say to the children, who's been asked to be in that kind of show? And they go, And I said, well, Mummy's been asked to be in Doctor Who. And the three of them just went, do it!
I'll be doing them a service.
It's Doctor Who. Has anybody ever said no to being in Doctor Who?
Well, while Keeley heads off to become the spirited Ms. Delphox, I think we should go meet the bank-busting posse. Jenna, who have we got?
Sai and Sabre, yeah. And they're part of the gang, the team, and they're great. They both have their own skills. Sabre has a mutant gene. It's an amazing gift, and I think Clara's kind of quite fascinated by it. And then there's Sai. He's a cyborg.
Supply line. It's your basic life support.
He can download and all sorts of technical stuff.
Time to meet Jonathan, I think. He can tell us who Sai is.
So I play Sai, who's an augmented human. I've got two USB ports, and he can get up information that he's downloaded onto the mainframe. That is Sai.
Nice! Can you plug your phone in as well?
Maybe that's a good idea. I can put it in my pocket and plug it in and see if I can take a call on my Bluetooth.
So then, Jonathan, would you be a cyborg in real life?
Oh, yeah, definitely a day. There's nothing he can't really do. He's got Google in his brain. Can you imagine the pub quizzes that you'd win?
Well, it's obvious why the Doctor picked you to be in his gang. But what about the other one, the one with the mutant gene? She looks like she really enjoys being a shapeshifter.
Well, my costume's very cool, very drapey and kind of quite mysterious and gothic. So, yeah, I love it. I love it all, especially the boots. When I saw the plan for my hair and my makeup and stuff, I said, oh, my God, that's so cool, midnight blue. I'd quite like to be a shapeshifter. I think it'd be quite cool. Could get boring, but at first it'd be fun.
OK, who would you imitate?
Hands down, Beyoncé. Saw her in concert like a week ago, in love.
Well, I think it's time we caught up with our spirited clone, Ms. Delphox. So, is Keeley anything like her character in real life?
Ms. Delphox, it's nothing like me, I'd like to think. No, she's really mean.
And what about Ms. Delphox?
She's a bit naughty. I like her. I do have a bit of sympathy for Ms. Delphox because at any given moment, you know, she is going to get her memory sucked out.
Fired with pain.
And it seemed Jenna quite admired Keeley's character too.
She's wonderful with her glasses and kind of that sweet vixen, but you know that has that bite.
Are you ready for your close-up?
So it's a fantastic mix, a fantastic baddie to have.
Dispose of our guests.
This feisty character isn't the first fearsome female the Doctor has come up against who managed to combine villainy and glamour. The 6th and 7th Doctors faced this time lady, Rani, a cold, calculating scientist who believed her experiments were more important than human life. And this intergalactic criminal known as Caesar of Diplos almost defeated the 4th Doctor, whilst Helen A proved a ruthless dictator who tried to outlaw unhappiness. More recently, the Doctor faced one of the universe's most cunning villains, who you probably remember like this, the Lady Cassandra.
Moisturise me.
But in terms of pure evil, our Queen of Mean nudges ahead of the terrifying Matron Cophelia and the deadly Rosanna Calveri. Yes, the crown goes to the murderous Madame Kavarian.
Against who?
Against you, Doctor.
Well, Ms. Karabraxos fits onto that list quite nicely. Anyway, in this episode, we also see the introduction of a new Doctor Who creature, the Teller.
What is that?
It's a wonderful creation. It was actually wonderful to shoot with it because with the Teller, it actually looked alive.
The Teller will now scan your thoughts for any criminal intent.
I really like the Teller. He's so realistic, you know, the animatronics and everything. It's quite incredible that his eyes on the end of his little antennae, you know, and they're blinking away and sort of looking, and they go like this and look at you. When they started doing it, everybody was like, whoa!
Sometimes with special effects, you have to use your imagination a great deal, and sometimes you're not sure whether or not you're giving the right level of awe. But with the Teller, it was all happening, so that was great.
Guilt has been detected. Your account will now be deleted, along with your mind.
There's something so real and vulnerable about him, as strange as that seems.
Supper time.
Initially, we think he's a baddie. I'm pleased we find out that he's not.
Turning his brain into soup. Turning his brain into soup.
Have a lovely day.
Well, despite being able to turn your brain into soup, the Teller was good after all. Some passing fans even managed to get a sneaky glimpse of him as he wanders off into the sunset.
Cut.
And a lucky few also got to meet the new Doctor.
It was nice. It's always nice to see people. The fans are so friendly and supportive, and it's good that they get to get a glimpse of what's going on.
With Peter being a big fan of the show, does he get to know all the storylines?
I have a thing with Stephen. I often say to him that I don't really want to know what's going to happen because I'm not sure that that knowledge would alter my performance. I just want to enjoy it when I read the script.
So much mental traffic in the universe. The only solitude. It's the wrong line.
You've got one line.
I get told things on a need-to-know basis, but otherwise, I like to let it unfold.
It turns out Peter isn't the only fan on set.
Cut, very good.
The director Douglas isn't so reserved about getting the gossip on Doctor Who.
When I first pick up a script, I'm thinking I'm ahead of everybody else. And I love reading scripts. I even read the scripts that I'm not directing because I love it so much. It's very exciting.
So what's it like working with Peter Capaldi?
Peter's great. He knows his stuff. He knows his acting. He just fills his boots with pleasure every day.
So then, Douglas, can you tell us a precious Doctor Who secret?
When we were putting together the most precious things in the universe for the Carabraxos lair, one of the objects that I wanted in there was a tiny little rocket made out of a toilet roll that my daughter Ruby made for me and gave to me for Christmas. It's there because I think it's one of the most precious things that I have.
And now for something that's made a return in this episode, the memory worm.
Don't touch it!
I love the memory worms. The memory worm was in the Snowman episode. It's one of the first scenes where Clara meets the Doctor and he tries to give her a memory worm, but Strax keeps getting it wrong and wiping his own memory.
When?
Memory worms are great. Love the memory worms.
We caught up with the worm operator to find out what makes this worm wriggle.
It works a lot like a brake on a bicycle. So there's four wires running down the middle. As you move it, it works like the tendons in your hand, so it moves the worm and pulls it and manipulates it. It takes a bit of practice to get used to it, but after about half an hour practice, I got it right.
So were there any difficulties when working with these wriggly worms?
Definitely holding above Peter's head, so it looked like the foam. That was a bit tiring, and we've had two people go on the go. He held one of the handles, I held the other while moving it, and then holding the wires high enough so it would stay out of the way of the camera. Definitely the hardest part.
And I hear these worms haven't quite been behaving on set.
Well, we were supposed to have two. Well, I've got my one, but we had another one. We've lost it. We're going to have to get everyone to start filming and just look for it. People are going to start losing their memories otherwise. Peter Capaldi loses his memory. We've had it.
Time to hunt down that memory worm.
I don't know where it is. I don't know where it's gone. I'm sorry.
What's a memory worm?
A memory worm? I think it was under the catering truck.
Best check under the catering truck, then. Nope, nothing there. Best ask the catering crew.
Don't tell the crew, but they had it for breakfast this morning. Hope they enjoyed it. Nobody complained.
Memory worm for breakfast. What's for lunch? Ah, chicken curry. Anyway, I think it's time we catch up with our bank-busting team and see how they've been getting on.
We are at a power station in Newport, and it's our final day today.
It's our final day. Shooting. It's hard work, but it's so rewarding, and Peter and Jenna have been really welcoming, and Everyone's been great. Now that you're here, you'd kind of want to stay.
Yeah, we don't want to go, do we? I tend to enjoy most jobs that I do, and then I cry at the end of them, which is a bit late.
You're going to cry today?
I don't know, maybe. So good, and it's been really fun to be part of Doctor Who.
So, 1 year on, what do you think your characters are up to?
I think mine's on the straight and narrow.
Yeah, I think mine is too. And I think we see the Doctor and Clara from time to time. We meet up for a pint.
Sort of send tweets.
Yeah, we tweet, yeah, exactly.
Well, they've obviously had a great time making this episode, as did we. And you never know, we may be seeing this dynamic duo again someday.